Well, in neighboring Sudan, years of international efforts have failed to end a nearly decade-long rebellion in Darfur, where mostly non-Arab insurgents took up arms in 2003 to fight against what they called the Arab-dominated government's neglect of the region. A peace deal for Sudan's Darfur region, known as the Doha Agreement, has not been implemented due to a lack of funding, their failure to disarm militias, attacks on peacekeepers, and other problems nearly 18 months after it was signed. Now, for more insight into the Darfur situation, we are joined by Mini Minawi, a Darfuri and the leader of the Sudanese Liberation Movement. Mr. Minawi, welcome to In Focus.
Thank you.
Now, Darfur hasn't actually been in the news as much as it was a few years ago. Give us a sense of how things are right now on the ground in Darfur.
Thank you very much. Actually, Darfur is now, the situation is Darfur is very bad, and also is getting worse more than even 2003. Now Doha's agreement is failed. There's no agreement, and also UNMIT missions also is failed, and government of Sudan has dominated all the sectors and also including all the institutions there, and mobilizing the militias and killing the people and burying the villages, and even the humanitarian situation, it is very bad in Darfur. It needs to be helped.
Now, one of the reasons for the failure of the Doha Agreement is that actually most of the rebel groups in Darfur did not support this agreement, which was signed last year in the month of July. The question is, do you support Doha?
Actually, Doha's agreement is not signed between the movement and the government. Doha's agreement is just signed between the government and internally itself. And that's why it is one part of the agreement will not cannot do any job.
The liberation and justice movement is supposed to be
This is established by the government in Doha, and also for their own purpose. And the leaders of this man is brought from the UK and so on. This is number one. Number two is not the matter of agreement there or not there, but the problem is government of Sudan, NCP, is not get any desire and is not ready to sign any agreement, is not ready to implement any agreement, because I myself, I was one of the signatories.
But let's go back to 2006. Your movement, Sudan Liberation Movement, signed an agreement with the Sudan government, which was the Darfur agreement at that time. Mm. You signed it. Yes. You actually moved to Khartoum yourself.
Yes.
You stayed there. You became an advisor to the government of Khartoum, to the president of Sudan. Now, what happened to that agreement? What's the difference between that agreement and the Doha agreement?
That agreement, there are some differences. The differences is what. When we signed, we were really fighters, we were really movement on the ground. And different is this one, just they brought it from abroad. This number one.
But you are not also supported by some other groups? Did not support agreement.
This is different issues. There are supporters, there are non-supporters. Mm-hmm. It is normal. Even CPA, they are supporters, they are not supporters. Yeah. And UN, as the institution, many people not supporters, and that is why this is not problem. But the problem is NCP is not seeking to implement any agreement. NCP is going to genocide all the people of Darfur. Now genocide is existing in Darfur, and the killing of the people is going on. Omar al-Bashir is indicted, and Minister of the Defense is indicted. And Omar al-Bashir is discriminating the original and indigenous people of Darfur and killing them and displacing them and replacing by the Arab tribes from different countries of Africa. This is the situation.
Yeah, but at the same time, the rebel groups, including your group, SLM, the Minawi faction, have been accused of also killing people, raping people in the same region. And there are so many rebel groups operating in that region. So to what extent can you say that the rebel groups themselves have not been party to these atrocities that are being committed in Darfur?
I told this is not true. This is NCP's speech, SCP government talking like that.
But you fight amongst yourselves. You're not a united front. You don't have a united rebel group.
It's unity is not the matter. Unity of the purpose is the matter. But unity as the body, this doesn't matter because now there is SRF, and this is SRF about the three movement from Darfur, now part of the SRF. This is number one. Number two, 7,000 villages and cities been burned by the NCP government. Mm-hmm. When villages, you cannot mention that's burned by the rebel group.
We don't have a lot of time. Mm-hmm. In your from your perspective, what is the best solution now to the Darfur situation, once and for all?
The best solutions is holistic solutions, is comprehensive solutions, including Darfur issues. Because since 2000 or 1972, many solutions came in Sudan. All solutions failed because they were partial solutions. That is why SRF now issuing the holistic solutions in a general manner, a comprehensive manner.
Okay. I hope when you come back, you'll tell us about peace in Darfur at that time. Eh? We wish you all the best.
I will. Thank
you. Well, Mr. Minawi, thank you very much. And Amini Minawi is a Darfurian, the leader of the Sudanese Liberation Movement. Thanks a lot for joining us here. And we want to know what you think about In Focus and the stories we cover. Join the conversation on the Facebook. The address is VOA In Focus, and you can check the headlines 24/7 at voaafrica.com.